Hi, so today we want to talk about higher order derivatives. And so it turns out this thing we've been calling the derivative is really the first in a series of derivatives that we can take of a function, and it's really called the first derivative. That is the function that results in taking the derivative one time. Then if I take the derivative a second time, like the derivative of the derivative, I get the second derivative. So let's just maybe kind of make a note of these things. So the first derivative I call f prime of x, and I have my original function. Maybe I'll write this down. F of x is the original. And we know how to take this first derivative. So, and then we have something called the second derivative, which I write and denote with these two little apostrophes here. This is called the second derivative. Derivative. And it is, just so that we understand, the derivative, like I get it by taking the derivative of f prime of x. F prime of x is a function. I treat it just like that, and I take its derivative. Okay? You can do this, as many times as you want, really. This is the third derivative. I find the third derivative by taking the derivative of the second derivative, right? When I go to the fourth derivative, I, instead of putting like a whole bunch of dashes here, usually put a little four right there. Fourth derivative. And same for fifth, sixth, seventh. Like that. Okay? There's also similar notation with these d, like we have this d by dx or df by dx. For the second derivative, it's a second derivative with respect to x twice. And this kind of notation keeps going like that. Okay? So let's just do an example where we take a derivative, several derivatives. So let me have this function be 5x to the fifth, a polynomial we'll look at. Minus 3x squared plus 7x minus 5, right? And so I know how to take, so find, let's say the question is find f prime of x, f double prime, or the second derivative, the third derivative, and let's say the fourth derivative. Okay? So I want to go ahead and do that. I definitely know and can use all of my rules in order to take the first few derivatives. So let's go ahead and compute this, f prime of x. And I use this power rule, so I get 25x to the fourth plus 12x squared minus 6x plus 7, and the 5 becomes 0. There's my first derivative. Now, to take the second derivative, f double prime of x, I'm looking at this function right here, and I'm just going to take the derivative of that using the same rules that I have been using. So, really, I get 25, just to make sure this clear, 4x cubed, right? Plus 12 times 2x minus 6. And then the derivative of x is 1x to the 0, right? Or just 1. And the derivative of 7 is 0. I just want to be explicit about where these numbers are coming from here. So this is 100x cubed plus 24x minus 6. That's the second derivative. Okay? Okay. We'll do the third derivative. Same sort of idea. I'm going to look at this function right here, the second derivative, and take the derivative. So I get 300 x squared plus 24. There's the third derivative. With polynomials, they get kind of smaller and smaller. The degree keeps going down when you take the derivative. And so let's do one more, the fourth derivative of x. Unless it's 600x, I think. That's it. Okay? So taking these derivatives does just involve taking the derivatives of kind of a different function, derivatives of derivatives. You sometimes do have to use the product rule. You sometimes have to use the quotient rule. So let's do maybe one more example. I want to do an example where we're using the quotient rule. F of x is equal to x minus 4 over x. Let's just take a couple of derivatives, find the first and second derivative. Okay, so let's go ahead. I do have to use the quotient rule for this one. So quotient rule. I have two things divided by each other. They both contain x. So in this case, f is the numerator, right? In this quotient rule thing, or you can call it, this is what I think of as the top, right? X minus 4, and this f prime is just 1. The bottom is just x, and that's what we usually call g, and g prime is just 1 again, okay? So, and the quotient rule tells me that this derivative should be g f prime, the bottom times the derivative of the top, minus the top times the derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. So let me go ahead and plug this in. Let's see, g is just x, and f prime is 1, minus f, and g prime is just 1. And g squared is x squared. So, and this is my original function, f prime. So let me simplify this because I want to take the derivative again. I have a purpose in simplifying. Minus x plus 4 over x squared. And this simplifies to just be, I think, 4 over x squared for the first derivative. Is that what you guys get? Okay, so 4 over x squared, now I want to take the second derivative, right? This is a good problem. Kind of shows when we need to be using the product rule, and when, or the quotient rule, and when we shouldn't. So let me go ahead and write this down. 4 over x squared. Because I want to take the derivative again, right? F prime of x is equal to 4 over x squared. And here, since there's no variable in the numerator, I can rewrite this and should rewrite this as 4x to the minus 2 power. Then use the general power rule to take this derivative. It will be much easier, much cleaner, and much faster than using the quotient rule. Okay? So f double prime of x is 4 times negative 2x to the minus 3. Negative 8x to the minus 3 power, which I'll write as negative 8 over x to the minus, not minus, right? X to the third. Once I move it, the negative goes away. Okay? Okay, so those are taking the derivatives. We will be needing to choose the appropriate rule. So please start thinking to yourself, like, which one is most expedient? There are a bunch of different ways to work these. Some of them will be faster and more clean than other ways. This is a faster method than using, say, for example, the quotient rule on this second derivative. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions.